hard polo, and most of them have come out with a few bumps and bruises. But aside from that hand injury of Adolfo, injury-wise for players, it's been a good year too.
It has. I think there's been a few others, like Nacho had a problem with a muscle in his leg there and some things like that. But Paco, he got bumped off a horse the other day, and the poor guy landed right on his hip and couldn't finish that game. But you're right. I think Adolfo's the only one that's that stayed out.
All right, we got a penalty shot coming up from midfield. This is 150 yards from goal, under 2 minutes left in the first half. This is Paco. He pushes the first one, then he decides to lay one up front. He's looking for Merlos, but Facundo is first man to get there. Look at Magoo. He rides out of the pack and picks it up. Magoo coming wide, trying to get in front of the two defenders. Facundo takes him out of it. Now it's Magoo still in control. He doesn't want to hit past that defender, so he's trying to keep it tight and close to see if he can get a horse race out of it. Little flip pass up to Facundo. He tries to switch over to the right, but he's lost the ball. Merlos is there to recover. Tincho Merlos with a minute 15. They've got the ball. They'd like to knock one more in before we get to the half. That would definitely close the gap for him. Merlos at midfield. Laprida trying to keep him, to slow him down just a little bit, to box him out. Tincho still in control. He's in a lot of pressure there, but he's still got the ball. He's carried it over 150 yards by himself. There's the back shot for Cigar to clear it out, but it'll be ERG there to save it. Little flip shot to the outside. Player couldn't go in there. That was way too close, too dangerous. Now it's Magoo. 40 seconds left. We'll hear that 30-second warning horn coming up here. Facundo taking his time. Big reach way behind the tail of the pony. Now he's got 30 seconds to go. Merlo's trying to give him a push. Look at these guys battling for the ball, pushing and shoving, and Facundo holds on to win it. Now he's run into another Merlos, and there goes the whistle. Whew. 20 seconds to go. It's getting heated out there, Jim.
It is. I'll tell you, those Merloses are tough, though. I love watching them play. They're great defenders, as you can see there. He got by, Facundo got by one of them. The other one was there. Made a mistake and got a little over the line, but great hustle.
Yeah, these guys have played together since they're little tiny kids, and so they know how to read each other on the plays, and they know how to back each other up on the field because they're basically the core of this ERG team. They're playing in the middle at 1 and 2, and it's their job to make it happen both on offense and defense. Umpires call for a timeout to sort out what happened there. We won't want to second-guess them here. We got a warning whistle here because we've had a little bit of complaining here. Whether or not they move it up, we'll see. 20 seconds left. We're in the first half of the second game about to end. Jimmy Newman has been here, the polo manager from International Polo Club Palm Beach, and helping us with the commentary. We're under the time, so we have ended the first half. It is 8-6. Zakara leading ERG by 2.
The Polo Training Foundation.
It's been wild. I mean, that first game was crazy. Were you over there for that one?
You know, I got over there at the very tail end. I mean, what a great finish that was right there. A little surprising, but good luck to them.
This looks like a tight ball game as well. Only two goal separation, and ERG was in a little trouble, but they've come back too.
You know, it's really amazing. You know, take advantage of a few opportunities, and you see what happens over here. So we'll have to see how the second half goes.
Jimmy Newman is talking in the first half about all the activities you got planned for Sunday. What's going to be going on?
You know, I don't want to give in to all the different surprises, but we'll have a lot of entertainment here, a lot of things that will attract the family. Parachutists, you know, some skydivers, maybe a flyover or two. So there's a lot planned, but, you know, we're really here for the polo.
But Jimmy was just kidding then when he said you were actually going to jump out of the plane.
Well, I hope I don't have to jump out of the plane.
But that's not in the job description, right?
It isn't. You know, I say I'm a company man. I'll do whatever I need to do, but that might be taking a little far, Ron. I'll do it if you do it.
No. We're done. We're not doing it. John, congratulations on a great season. Look forward to Sunday. It's going to be a huge grand finale for you.
Well, I certainly appreciate it, and thank everybody for being here and supporting International Polo Club.
Thank you, John Walsh.
All right, thank you.
John Walsh, the general manager, the guy who's made all the magic happen here over these last few times, and super job for him. Hey, man, I'm good. How are you doing?
Good to see you.
Congratulations on a good season.
Thank you.
Get around here so all the girls can see that
all
face.
All right, there we go.
Look at that. Man, you're like a teen idol polo star. How do you handle all that? It's just part of it.
Just try to be as humble as possible, I think.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You've done that. You've done that.
Yeah, of course.
I mean, you're just a kid. You won the U.S. Open when you were in high school, and it's like, I don't know, maybe I'll go fishing for the rest of my life. But
Yeah. You've
become a superstar in your own right. You're one of the best American players, but you are in the spotlight more than a lot of other guys. I mean,
look, you got to stay humble, and you got to just focus on, you know, what you're doing, and, you know, and be disciplined, and try to, do the best that you can, and set a good example for all the young kids that are coming. So.
This is you live online. There are 10,000 people watching, 10,000 people around the world.
Wow,
and there are girls that want me to ask you this. You ready?
Yep.
Who's he dating now?
I am dating a girl named Jessica Schuster from New York.
Okay.
Yep. So it's been about 6 months, and she's great. She's amazing. So we're both very happy, and we'll see where it takes us.
All right. Tell me about your polo plans after the season.
I'm going to England after this. I'm gonna play the first two weekends of Grand Champions here with the Ganzies, and then I go to England for 2 months. I'm gonna just play some, just try to get some exposure, play some medium goal. It might be a chance to play the Queens of the Gold, and then Santa Barbara again with the Ganzies, and then the fall season with the Ganzies as well. So my season is pretty much booked up. So
yeah. Good for you. That's how it should be. Thank you, buddy.
No,
good to see you.
Good to see you. Thank you.
Right. I want to be like you when I grow up. Joe Meyer, come on over here. I'm good. We're live on Polo Line TV.
Great.
We got, I think they said 10,000 people are watching right now. So
that's
you
got to
keep the audience. Don't worry about a thing. No pressure here.
That's great. Well, we, obviously a great game, two great games today. We're excited about being able to stream them live. I mean, it's fantastic. People around the world get to watch it for all the efforts that everyone's brought to the table. Today, I think Sebastian Merlos has figured out Facundo. I mean, he's on him a lot more, guarding him a little bit more. So another great game. And obviously excited about what's happening with the TV and the streaming.
And you got a prediction here? You think this is going to tighten up, or you think Zakara is going to run away with it?
No, I think Zakara's got good chances. I mean, it'll be a good game, but I think Zakara, at the end of the day, I think they're playing well. Mike Azero's playing extremely well. Magula Prida is they're all playing well. Linden gets in on the play. I mean, it's just they're playing well together.
For everybody watching, we have faces up here. People know the players, but you're kind of behind-the-scenes mover, shaker kind of guy. Tell everybody what your role is with the USPA.
I'm the secretary of the U.S. Polo Association, and I'm also the chairman of the marketing committee. So we've spent a lot of time working on how do we grow the brand and grow the sport of polo. We're very much intrigued by getting new players in, new sponsors in, new younger players, elevating the U.S. polo players to allow them to become better polo players and really make the sport available to more people and make them aware of it. So we're really investing in streaming. We're investing in other TV strategies, and that's really what we're focused on right now.
Joe, congratulations and good job. Keep up the good work.
Thanks, Ron. Really appreciate it. You guys do the same. All right, bye-bye.
All right. Robert Jernavis, welcome. How are you, buddy?
Very good. How's it going?
Good. This has been a super year for you. You came down here and you knocked a few people around, and all of a sudden it's like, who's this college guy coming down here beating everybody's butt?
Yeah, well, not a college kid yet. It was a really fun season. I had a lot of fun. I was really lucky to be able to play on the team that I did and have the success that I did. It was really fun.
A little bit heartbreaking when that ball hit Adolfo in the back of the hand. I mean, now you had a lot of success up to that point, but you still kept it going, and you still finished off with a nice season.
Yeah, you know, that's polo. You know, there are injuries, and everybody, you know, no one's immune to it. So it was a tough year. You know, it was tough that happened just before the U.S. Open, and because everything was going so well, the whole team was really great, and Pilon and Alejo were both playing so well, and, you know, but it happens. So.
Tell us about your personal plans now. Do you have to go back to school, or can we talk to your dad and twist his arm a little bit?
No, I'm going back to school in September. And
you get to play this summer at home?
Yeah, we'll play in Denver and hang out in Denver, and we play some fun polo, and so we'll have a good time.
Hope to see you back here next winter for sure.
I hope so, too.
We'll work on him, all right?
Yeah, thanks. Buddy.
Good to see you. Robert Jernavis, a team captain of one of those great Valiente teams, is doing a super job here.
Andamos probando un poco.
Sebas.
Second half of this match today. Slow start for ERG, but they have managed to really battle back here in the third chucker. A very strong performance for them, and they only trail by two now. The winner will be going ahead to face Lechuza Caracas in the finals. And Lechuza, of course, the defending champion. Here's Merlos. Tincho with the ball at the back of the pack. Azaro waiting for him. Augustine with a little short shot. Trying to get up to Wood. It's flipped out of there quickly, though, by Lyndon Lee. It's Azaro. Mike Azaro for the Black Zakara team. Facundo on the pickup, the follow-up shot. He lays it right down in front. Mike switching left, right. It's Magu Laprida. Magu. A beautiful pass from Facundo to Magu, and Magu worked it on both sides of the pony, and he sent it on home, and they widen the gap now to 9-6. 6:30 to go. We've only played a minute here of the fourth period. The semifinals of the Nespresso U.S. Open Polo Championship. Facundo, he is surrounded by orange players. Downfield into the corner by the boards. Merlos with the ball. Merlos getting it turned around now, trying to get it back to the north end. Little flip pass up front. Sebastian can't connect on the far boards over there. Lee with a back shot. Wood trying to get in on that ball. Now he can't connect to it. He's left it behind. Facundo comes through the pack. He may have fouled coming in there. We'll see what happens as the umpires stop the clock. Forty-yard penalty shot coming up here for ERG. They'll need this one. It's 5:49. Clock has stopped, of course, for the penalty shot. This will get them back within two again. That's as close as they've been able to get here because they got behind 3-0 right away in that first period. Merlos circling the horse, takes it back about 40 yards, comes back up to the ball. Winds up, hard hit on target, you betcha. Merlos, he's closed the gap. It's 9-7 now. Zakara with a two-goal lead. Back into play to the outside on the left. Paco with a nice backhander. Yep, Desaro's back shot gets deflected and ERG ends up with it. Big run to goal. Lyndon Lee with a nice backhander to steal it away. Orange still trying to capitalize on it. Here's Azaro. Azaro lays it down to midfield. Nice hard shot. Merlos is there. Merlos, back shot, deflected up in the air, and it stays on the field right there. Back shot by Paco. Big reach in front, Facundo. Facundo reaching around, turning it to the left. Facundo checks up now, about 80 yards out. Merlos slides in, takes the ball away from him, but the umpires didn't like the looks of that. So let's blow the whistle, stop the play. That'll be 4:30 now left in the fourth. And we've got another extra whistle, which means there's somebody in trouble out there because the umpires don't like any after talk. Once the play has been called and set up, you just go to the play and set your team up. No talking. Thanks, everybody, for watching around the world, our special audience in Dubai and Argentina and all over the United States. We're glad you're here with us today. Of course, we'll be bringing you multi-camera coverage when we get to the finals on Sunday. That'll be 4 o'clock Eastern Daylight Time here in South Florida. The winner today going against Lechuza Caracas. Facundo will take the penalty shot. Easy walk up. Winds up. On the way, and he's got it. Facundo Pierres, and they take back their three-goal lead. They have led most of the game by 3 goals. Clock down to 4:10 to go. It's 10-7. Zakara in the black with a 3-goal lead. Players line up on the umpire. Third set of players get it kicked out. Merlos, nice little back shot. His brother picks it up. And attempted steal on the ball. Facundo doesn't get it. And another recovery on the ball. Lee's in there. But look at Magoo. Magoo comes sliding in there quickly with the ball. Magoo, he's surrounded by orange jerseys. He can't keep that. It's taken away by Paco. Paco taking it to the far side of the field. Facundo decides to change the direction on that play, but he had a man coming on his left, and I think they're going to call him for that, and we're going to pick it up and move it down to the 60-yard line. That penalty will stop the clock with 3:30 left in this period. Sixty-yard penalty shot coming up for Merlos again to try to get him back within two. Wind up, he's underneath. It's a high rocket, and he's right on target with that ball, so that'll make it 10-8. 3:20 now to go. We're in the fourth. Umpire puts the ball back in play. Here's Facundo playing at number one. He's been solid at that position. Normally he doesn't play that. Look at these two guys going for it right there. Paco and Facundo really after it. Merlos has it right off of the boards. Merlos loose and running. Merlos mishits. He wanted that to go to the left, but it went into the dead zone in that far right corner. Now we have a hard time getting to turn. Still in control. He's got Paco to block for him as he tries to go across the back. And Magoo comes in to hit it away, but the umpires didn't like the looks of that. Another foul to stop the clock at 2:30. Merlos with the backhander. Magoo, he's got room. Magoo lost the ball now as they get turned around coming back the other way. Paco over to Merlos. Merlos with a chance. He's got the shot, and he's got the goal. A great play, and all of a sudden, ERG in the last 3 minutes have come to life, and they're back in it. Sakara now clinging to just a one-goal margin. Again, thanks everybody for watching on Polo Line TV. We've gotten a lot of email messages and text messages. If you want to send us information about where you're watching from, we appreciate that. We know that our viewers are up to the 10,000 mark now, so call your friends. This game's definitely not over now. Zakara only with a one-goal lead. And again, we will be here with live coverage, six cameras, a full crew at 4 o'clock Eastern Time from South Florida for the U.S. Open Finals. Here's the pickup. Facundo Facundo on the outside. He's got two orange jerseys all over him. Now he tries to make a play, and he's lost that. Merlos on the gray gives him a push and knocks it out of there toward the far boards. And up to the boards, and the whistle goes, and we'll stop the clock again. Lots of fouls in this chucker. 1 minute left in the fourth. This is Facundo now getting ready to hit the penalty shot from the point of the infraction. The foul occurred over there about 100 yards out from that far east side board. Facundo takes the second shot. He's got a hard rolling grounder. It's going to go. He's going to overshoot to the outside right. And he had the distance, but not enough accuracy there. He needed to be a little bit more to the left. ERG will take over. They've got time for one more run if they can get it knocked in here. 50 seconds left in the period. Can they tie the game before the fourth ends? Here's their chance. Across field, not the shot that'll help them out time-wise. Attempted backhander by Merlos. Up by the boards. Now they manage to clear it out quickly. Augustine gets turned around. Merlos. Merlos, room to ride. The 30-second bell has sounded. We're down to 20 seconds left. Merlos from the outside. Sebi can't get it. He gets blocked out. And there's the back shot going the other way. Zakara keeps it on the field with the backhander toward the far boards. They're running out of time. Azaro is loose, but he's only got 2 seconds left. Azaro on the gray. He's going to have to hammer this one, and he's run out of time. The ball settles at about 80 yards out. A few more seconds, he could have had that. Big chucker coming up. We've got two to go. It is 10-9 in favor of Zakara. Welcome back to our live coverage on Polo Line TV. It's 10 to 9. ERG keeping their hopes alive with a strong performance in the last half of the fourth chucker. We're ready to go with chucker five. And joining us for the rest of the match is Joey Casey. If you're not an American player, maybe you don't know Joey Casey, but if you've been around polo at all, Joey, you've got a long history of polo going way back to Texas and Boca and a lot of other places. Tell us quickly about how this all evolved for your polo career.
Well, I started in Boca Raton back in 1983 was my first season with the Oxleys, and I played with the Oxley family until the 2007 when Jack retired, and then I reopened the club as Palm City Polo in Boca Raton, and we're still there. That's home for me in Boca, and I'm up in Wellington a lot with Melissa Ganzi, playing up here with her also, and it's been a great transition, and it's great to be able to come to IPC on these beautiful fields and stadium and watch a 26-goal open game.
All right, Joey Casey will be here, and he'll be giving us some good insight on this game as we move along. He certainly has a lot of experience at this level, and he'll be very helpful in helping us to keep up with all the action out there. This game has been really good so far.
It's been a great game. It's been a very physical game. The Merloses are really physical players, and there's some really hard bumps going on out there, and these guys are really playing hard today.
All right, 9-10. ERG, they've got to come to life and keep it going because they were a little lacking their first couple of chuckers on offense, but they've really, really come back. The winner going against Lechuza on Sunday. We'll have that for you live here on Polo Line TV starting at 4 Eastern Daylight Time worldwide. Ball is back in play and we're underway. Here's Azaro coming out of the back of the pack with it. Azaro trying to keep that close. A player slowing down on him in front. They cut the ball away from him, and the umpires jump on the whistle to stop the play. Think he was shading him a little too close in front when he was trying to come across field there?
Yeah, Mike was bringing the ball along, and the orange player crossed over to the right in front of him and right in his right away, and that's what they blew the whistle for.
Okay, so good break for Zakara now. That means they'll tee a ball up for them, and they'll get a penalty shot fairly close in. It stops the clock with 7:20 to go. Joey, this Palm City thing has really taken off now. You started last year, right?
Yeah, last year, yes.
And now you've got players coming in from all around the country and quite a bit of competition team-wise.
Yeah, it's been a great season. We have a 12-goal league and a 6-goal league, and I have a couple USPA national tournaments there, the President's Cup qualifier and the Association Cup at 8 goals. And things are picking up, and hopefully next year there'll be more interest and more people.
All right, here's Facundo on that close-in penalty shot, and he's targeted that thing. It's on the money, and he's got the goal. And again, they go back up by two by a score of 11-9. Facundo's been phenomenal last Sunday and again today. He's just really a tough, tough, awesome player.
Facundo has really picked his game up the last in the quarterfinals, and this game today has really rose to the occasion and playing extremely well.
All right, we are back in the middle. If you're watching online, we've got the black team going to your left now. There's the ball back in play. The horse kicks it out to the front. Magoo is on it. Magoo scoots it forward, then slips a little back shot the other way. And then the clearing shot for Facundo, but it doesn't go anywhere. Merlos will be there first. Tincho, little back shot, trying to clear it out to an open spot to find his brother. Merlos again. He's got an open man out front. It's his brother. That's the 1-2 punches. They open it up. We've got a horse race to the balls. It settles on the outside. Little tap shot. Here's the finisher under the neck and in the goal. He's got it. They're keeping alive. ERG now back within one. 6 minutes to go in the fifth, and it's 11-10. That's what we talked about when you first sat down, Joey. Those two guys are a tough 1-2 punch.
Yeah, they are. They know each other really well. They're brothers. They've been playing together their whole life, and they know what the other one's thinking every minute they're out there.
All right, we're bringing them back to the middle one more time to give it a go. ERG scoring to your right. This time they'll be going to the left. Ball kicks out to the right one more time. Merlos is there. Magoo trying to intercept on the backhander. Sebastian Merlos holding on to it. Nice steal there on the double swing. Player slides in front, picks up a great line as he's running to goal. Magoo Laprida centering it up. He's got room to ride. He goes in front. Player slides in behind. He can't get the hook. Here it is. And there's a tail shot, clearing it out beautifully by Merlos. Sebastian Merlos. And now Tincho hammers one downfield. Look at this. Scott Wood is all alone as it settles 60 yards out. Scott Wood riding hard to the ball. Winds up, pops it up in the air. There it goes. And he just missed the shot there. He was all alone in front. He had the chance, but he just missed it. That was the chance to tie as we go under 5 minutes now in this period. Azara will knock it in for Black. 300 yards to go to the other end. Here's Mike. Mike is going to keep it close till somebody breaks open. Now Facundo cuts across the middle, but Mike's lost the ball. There's the back shot coming the other way. Facundo will try to get there first. He's asked to leave it. Azaro goes to the play, and the whistle will stop the clock. We're down to 4:26 now. And we're going to pick this one up and chew up some real estate coming back the other way. Tough break there, Joey, for ERG on that.
Yeah, that was. Mike baited the guy in there. Mike was going to go back the ball, and he just waited long enough for that guy to come across the line.
Joe, you've played a lot of polo. That's one of the tricks. I mean, you've got to make that guy believe in what play is coming, and then you may not make the play, or you may try to just sucker him in there on that.
That's exactly right. That's a big part of it. And these guys are really good at that.
What kind of tournaments have you won in your career?
I've won the Pacific Coast Open. I've won the Canadian Open. I've won the USPA Gold Cup. I've won, I think, four international 26-goal Gold Cups. Won the Sunshine League three or four times, 26-goal tournament. Won the $25,000 International Cup. Off the top of my head, those are some of the ones.
That's enough, my friend. That's enough. That's good. Joey Casey, of course, here with us to help us with the analysis of the game. Azaro takes his second shot. It's a beauty. It's way downfield, and it's off to the left. There's Merlos trying to get it back out of there. And it's out of play. 4 minutes to go. We're in the fifth. Zakara now, they'll have a chance to make a run to the north end. Correction, it's ERG. ERG, second pickup by Merlos. Paco on the boards. Paco, hard place to keep the ball. He's lost it right there. Merlos on the recovery. Merlos holding it at the back on the gray horse. Now Paco slides around to try to help him out. Umpires didn't like the looks of that one, so we're going to stop the clock and have another penalty shot. Joey, you have any idea what happened there?
I believe they called walking, which means they'll have a throw-in.
Yeah, the rule there is that you can keep that ball for a couple of taps, but you pretty much have to move along with the ball.
Yeah, the idea is to speed the game up so players aren't slowing the game down too much. If he would have hit that ball just a little bit sooner, they wouldn't have called that foul. Obviously, I was completely wrong.
And your umpire rating is what?
Well, not very high right now.
You just went from A to C, I think. Yeah, it's tough over here. You know, we got a little slope on the field, and I mean, that's why we've got basically five guys watching this game. It's a huge advantage for them to be able to call this stuff.
Yeah, it is. You got to have a lot of experience playing polo, watching polo, and things like that to be a good umpire and know what's going on the field.
Well, we got a little bit of a timeout here. Some players have taken advantage of that by running and grabbing some extra horses. We got one player off a horse. I think he's maybe waiting for a spare to be delivered. Clock has stopped 3:24, 11:10, and no rest for the wicked. Joey, Grand Champions is going to start up here pretty quick.
Yeah, we start this Friday. It's going to be a lot of great polo, and we go through the last weekend in May. We've got some 12 to 16-goal polo action, and it's a really great time of year to play polo. It's the best time of year, actually, there is to play polo, April and May in Florida. The fields are growing. The fields are beautiful. Grand Champions has wonderful fields, and it's going to be a lot of fun this year. We've got some great pros, too.
All right. Okay. And, yeah, you stand corrected, right?
Yeah, so I'm back up to an A umpire. I was right on my call.
Nothing like demoting yourself for the wrong reasons. Here we are back in action. ERG with the ball. Merlos, he's leaving it behind. His brother will pick it up, try to work it on in there. They're inside of 20 yards, a little bit wide to the right. Scramble for the ball. Can he hang on to it? He's Paco turned the corner, but there's a whistle. We'll stop it again. 3 minutes left in the fifth. Umpires talk it over just a little bit. A lot of fouls in this game, unlike the first game. I don't know if you were at that first game, but that was an amazing polo game.
The first game was fun to watch. It was an open game, a running game. It was a much cleaner game than this game. This game's a lot more physical than the last game we just saw.
I think a lot of times, too, strategy-wise, you come out with a team. If you're going to play a running team, you want to play a controlled game, playing a controlled game. I don't know. Do you think that leads to more fouls?
Absolutely. The Merloses are trying to slow the game down and make it a lot scrappier game, and the Zakara team is a running team. So you got one team trying to do one thing and another team trying to do the complete opposite, and that slows the game down quite a bit.
All right, but we've got a tie ball game now as he pushed that last penalty shot in. We're down to about 2:40 left in the fifth. Another chucker, of course, coming up after this. We're tied at 11. Ball's back in play. Facundo takes the man on the outside. Look at Magoo. Very smart how he came in and picked that ball up. Now he tries to slide in between the two Merloses. Magoo lays it up front. It's a little bit short, though. Magoo, nice recovery. Magoo in heavy traffic now. Can he get in there and hit a next shot to goal? Nope. Taken away. Augustine Merlos on the gray, taking it on the far side of the field. Two players break the goal as Augustine lays it up to midfield. There's the back shot taken away by Zakara. It's Facundo getting a turnaround. Boom, and they slap together right there. Paco trying to push him out of it. Facundo gets the shot. Here's Paco again holding on to it. He's going to cut that back shot, getting it back to a teammate if he can. Working it on the far boards. A minute 40 left in this period. Now Facundo ends up with it. This guy is so cool and controlled from the back. He'll look for an opening and then roll in with it. Here he comes. Facundo. He's got one man to beat, and he slides up underneath, and there goes the whistle. That'll stop the clock with a minute 28 to go, tied at 11. Based on what we think happened, Joey, it looks like Facundo is pretty smart there. He saw everybody kind of collapsing on him on the outside there.
Yeah, and he hit that ball right up there and let that guy come right across the line. That was a very smart play he just made.
Well, the guy's 10 goals. You know, he's been there, done that so many times, and he's hard to defend in that regard. I mean, he's so smart with his ball control, and, you know, if you rate some of the best players in the world, we've seen some of the best play today between he and Nero and a couple other guys. The polo's been great here.
No, this season at IPC, the polo's been phenomenal. The best players in the world are here. Cambiasso, the Estradas, Nero. I mean, it's been amazing.
Okay, here is Facundo on the walk-up. Easy shot. He's under it. He's on the money, and he breaks the tie with a minute 20 left in the fifth. And Zakara goes up by a score of 12 to 11. All right, we'll bring it back to midfield now. Line them up, and again, we'll change the directions. Scramble for the ball, cut away by Merlos, intercepted by Magoo. Magoo Laprida's all over it. Now he's lost it. Facundo's there. Great stick work by this guy. Facundo trying to find room. There's Merlos. Double swings at it. He cuts it out of there. Horse race back to the ball. It's Azaro and Merlos. Merlos checks out of it. And Azaro angles the shot toward the near boards. Merlos quick to get that pony around to pick it up. There's his brother. And he slides in front of the player. He probably should have taken that on the left. And there's the whistle. Huge temptation there to make that happen. 26 seconds left in the fifth, 12-11. Belly high. So Black will get the ball. They'll put it right down where the foul occurred, and they've got a chance to make the run here. Joey, you can do this in 20 seconds, you think?
Yes, you can. He can do it with a few seconds to spare. My thought would be he's going to tap it a couple times and then shoot it down the field and try to get it to Magoo.
All right, let's see what plays out here. Facundo, first tap. Merlo's waiting for him. Now he hammers a wallop. It's a beautiful pass downfield. Azaro checking up. He almost comes off the horse, waiting for it to go over his head. There's Magoo. He can't get to it. Now Magoo's on the follow-up. Magoo in traffic. Merlo's cuts it back out of there. There's an attempt on the backhander, and we got a foul to stop the clock. So the clock is stopped with 7 seconds left in the chucker. ERG's really determined to keep that thing out of there down there. I mean, they collapsed on that thing.
Oh, they collapsed. Yeah, they did. They're really playing hard now. They've got to put all their marbles on the table, especially the next chucker, the sixth chucker.
All right, what can they do in the last 7 seconds now? They wallop the first ball to bounce short of the midfield marker. Zakara cuts it away. That'll probably chew up the rest of the time. And we have played five. It is 12-11. And we'll be back with the last chucker.
Okay, we are here with Sapo Cassette. Congratulations. You had an awesome game. It was an awesome game to watch. Amazing. You guys are back to defend your title.
Yes. We are back in the final day. You know, it was our goal, you know, when we started the season to defend the title. And, well, here we are.
We talked to Victor afterwards. He couldn't be happier. I mean, he was just smiling from ear to ear.
Yes, you know, like I said, we were thinking to be in the last day in the final of the U.S. Open. For us, it's the most important tournament here. So we made it to the final. We're really happy. I think the horses are good, and today we had a really good game.
Do you want to play ERG or Zakara?
Oh, both teams are really tough, you know. So whoever comes, it's a final, you know, we know it's going to be tough.
Your horses all good?
Yes, definitely. Well, I have to go to the barn, but as long as I know, yeah.
Perfect, man. Thank you. Congratulations. We'll see you Sunday.
Vale, gracias.
Sapo Cassette. It's 12-11. It's Zakara hanging on to a one-goal lead. They have led the entire game, but I wouldn't give up on ERG. Joey, we got 7 minutes of polo left here. Anything can happen, really.
ERG's hung in there the whole game. They were down three or four of the first chucker, and they fought back. They're a tough team. I mean, this is anybody's ball game right now.
All right. Of course, the horses will play a critical role here. Everybody saving the best for last in all probability, so we'll see how it plays out, if they've got the horsepower, the pony power to keep this thing going. ERG trying to come back. Winner will go against Sapo and that Lechuza Caracas defending champions on Sunday. Umpire waiting for the lineup that he wants. Players on each side of the line. Now he puts it in play, and the horse kicks it out to the left side. It's Facundo. Facundo in control. Merlos shadowing him. Magoo drops in behind to back him up in case he gets in trouble. Now Facundo slides a grounder downfield. It's going to be way wide to the outside. Joey, that's a tough shot to hit. You got that guy shadowing you in front. You can't get the angle underneath, and maybe, I don't know, do you hit it again or do you hold it there?
Well, he's going to try to take the shot, but the guy was so far to the right, it was a really difficult shot to make. Maybe he should have tapped it out to the right one time, tried to speed up so he had a little less angle shooting at the goal.
All right, here comes the ERG. They'd like to make a score on this run if it's possible. Back shot, going the other way. Uh-oh, whistle goes. And a whistle on the play, so we'll stop the clock. 6:34 on the clock. Do I put you on the spot here, Joey, and ask for your opinion?
From my vantage point where I saw that, we're at the ground level. It's harder to see, but I thought he was okay on that play. From up top where the cameras are, it'll be an easy play to see. But from where we're sitting, I thought he was okay, and I think they'll have a throw in.
All right, the umpires are in conference, and usually when you see them riding together, they're kind of talking it over, and they'll make a decision to either go to the third man or the thing gets negated, and we'll have a throw-in, which is exactly what Joey said. So there you go. You got your A rating back.
Two. I'm two for two now.
We're going to make a professional umpire out of this guy before the game's over today. And before we can get it underway, the umpire's asking for another lineup here. Now it's underway. Third set of players grab it. Kicked out to the outside. Near side pickup by Azaro. Azaro under pressure has left it behind. It's Facundo. Facundo in traffic. He's just trying to punch it out of there, but he can't find room to get it. Azaro comes back to save it. Azaro makes a turnaround. Nobody was on him. Now it's cranked out of there by Orange. Orange with a chance. This could be a breakaway one. We got two on one. Orange is going to cross the line with two players in front. Second man, is he going to take the defender? No. Defender is loose. Merlos slowing it down 75 yards, rolling it down to 30 yards. There's the push and the goal. Yes, he's got the goal. And the game is tied at the 5:45 mark. It's 12 all. Lee was in hot pursuit there, but he just didn't have the pony power.
No, that was a great play by Augustine to meet that ball and get it up to Sebastian. That was really a great team play they just made.
All right, so we'll come back. The team in black took a commanding early lead in this game, and all of a sudden they are now tied, and there's only 5 minutes left in the game. Ball is back on the field. This is Mike Azaro. He has been a workhorse for this team, almost gets unseated there as he hangs on. Merlos. Merlos will go against Facundo on the run to goal. Here they come. There's pushing and shoving, and Facundo wins the ride off and backs it up the other way. Merlos goes in front, but it looks like he cut off Magoo. And if that's the case, we're going to pick it up and move it back to the north side. Game's a little more open in this chucker, Joey. I'm kind of liking that part of it.
Yeah, I'm liking it, too. It's a lot better game to watch when it's open.
What's your call on this one?
I'd say it's going to be a penalty five, center hit.
All right, we'll bring it up here. We'll set it up, and see what happens as they lay it down at the midfield line. And as Joey said, this will be a midfield hit. That's 100, and that white line is 150 yards away from the north goalpost. So tell us about Grand Champions teams. You know who's playing starting this, I guess it would be the spring season, right?
Yeah, this weekend we've got Nick Roldan playing, Jeff Hall playing. We've got Juan Bellini playing, Chris Campson's playing. We've got a lot of high goal players playing this weekend. It's going to be a great weekend.
All right, good deal. Well, they take the penalty shot, and they do a couple little push shots, and somebody jumps in front, and I think we're going to pick it up, and this is going to be costly because we're going to chew up a lot of real estate here. We're at midfield. Now we're going down where any 10-goal player could make this shot on an average day.
Yeah, on an average day they could, but it's not as easy as it looks. When you're out there, it's a little tougher than it looks. They make it look really easy.
Talking about Grand Champions again, I'm thinking you're going to be in a shirt out there on your horses too, huh?
Yep, I'll be playing in it, as well as Diego Cosio, and we've got a really good lineup this year. They've had a really good lineup the last couple years, and this year is going to be the same.
And Grand Champions has been a huge success because they've come up with a concept that has really found its own niche. The patrons that come here, they just love playing at Grand Champions.
Well, we, you know, offer what everybody wants. It's a turnkey operation. They come in, we mount the sponsors. Some sponsors bring their own pros. You have the option to bring your pro, or we supply the pros for you. So it's a great way for people to get into the sport and get to play with players they'd never be able to play with otherwise. And it is a great concept because it whatever your polo needs are, we can suit it.
All right. Facundo on the money. And now they take back the lead with 4:40 left in the game. It's Zakara 13 and ERG 12. We'll come back to the middle once again. Zakara having scored to your left. They'll be going to the right now. Quick throw in and picked up by Magoo. Magoo, Merlos looks over his shoulder like, where were you on the throw in? Magoo's got the pony power. He's beat him to the ball. Magoo. Outside, there's the run, the goal. Wow, two goals back-to-back within 30 seconds. Merlos, look, brother standing in the midfield like, what the heck happened here?
Well, he's not happy. Somebody didn't cover their man, or somebody thought they got fouled. That was one of the most important throw-ins of the game to put Zakara two goals up.
And the game is won or lost sometimes at the throw-in.
It is, absolutely. That's exactly right.
All right, Scott Wood not happy about what just developed there as that throw-in came, and all of a sudden it was just a loose ball and nobody could catch him. Now we're back in play, 3:30 left in the game. Zakara back to their two-goal lead. It's not comfortable enough. There's still plenty of time. This is Merlos at the back. Merlos trying to get it out of traffic. Merlos is still coming with it. There's the attempt at the steal. No good by Facundo. Sebastian Merlo still walking it to the outside. Now Paco ends up with it. Paco's within scoring distance. Can he make it? And there goes the whistle. And a lot of commotion down there. We get that double whistle once again to kind of keep a lid on the noise. It stops the clock at 3:05. Again, when you got the ball and everybody slows down, it's like a magnet. Everybody just closes in on the thing, and more times than not, there's going to be a foul.
Yeah, because everybody wants it. You know, those guys are trying to defend with everything they've got. When those guys are dribbling that ball coming in like that, it's really hard not to cross in front of them.
And of course, now with this little bit of a break, some guys are taking advantage to go grab another horse because these last 3 minutes, the horse is going to mean everything if the game opens up.
Horse, right now at this point in the game, the horses are going to be everything from here on out. And this is a very important throw-in coming up for Orange if they convert this penalty too, which they should.
All right. We got a slow, easy walk up to it. He's got it up in the air. And it's in. The ball is in. And they close the gap again. Under 3 minutes left, it's Zakara 14 and ERG 13. So we're coming back to midfield. And as Joey Casey said, this is the throw-in they must win to stay in this ball game. The clock is against both teams, but the way Zakara has played, they would obviously be a favorite here. If they can score on this run, that would pretty much take ERG out of it. So Zakara trying to win the throw-in. ERG needs to win it and score. And they do. Merlo swats a beautiful ball downfield. It goes to no one, though. And Facundo is there for the takeaway. Paco trying to hassle him up against the boards. A lot of determination there. Paco trying to get it straightened out. Facundo's going to have to give way to him now. Now Paco trying to release the ball downfield. A little bit short. Cut away. Clock shows 2 minutes now left in the game. That's all we've got to go. 2 minutes. Paco gets turned around. He's got one player to beat. Paco keeping it close. Azaro can't do anything but look right now. He can't go in front of him. Paco slows down. Leaves it for Merlos. Merlos is going to try to walk it in. There's the cutaway by Zaccaro. There's the back shot. Intercepted by Zaccaro in front. No go. They chewed up a ton of time. Not good for ERG. Merlos, back shot. Over to Paco. 1:30 left in the game. Paco. Paco's got room to ride. There's Facundo on another great takeaway. Zaccaro has been super on defense in this last minute of play. Up against the boards. 1:15 left. Orange needs one goal to force it into overtime. This is Merlos. Merlos in the air, reaches behind. Now he's overrun the play. There's his brother trying to back it up, but it's no good. Magoo lays it against the boards. There's 1 minute left in the game. Magoo waiting for the rebound. Magoo centers it up. Merlos is there. Merlos cuts it away. Gets deflected. Lucky break for Zaccaro. Zaccaro with 45 seconds to go. Magoo hammers it toward the back line and run it out of play. And that's probably going to finish the game. 40 seconds to go. We're counted down. The seconds tick away. And they knocked it in. They still got 30 seconds. They're still alive. Merlos switching it over to the other side. Now the takeaway. Again, it's deflected. 20 seconds left. It's Facundo. Facundo, he fires one off the field. It's no good. That's going to end it. It's Zaccaro going to the U.S. Open Finals in a 14-13 win over ERG. Joey, that was one heck of a finish.
Hey, it doesn't get more exciting than that. I mean, that was an incredible finish. Any team could have won. Who would have thought that ERG was going to come back after the first two chuckers today, but they did. And they played an incredible game. So did Zaccaro. So everybody ought to be happy today.
Well, there was a big scramble down there. ERG really pushing that ball in there, and Zaccaro managed to get it out and clear the way, which that really was the big break in the last minute.
Yeah, that back shot Facundo made and hit about 90 yards was incredible. Absolutely incredible.
Joey Casey, thanks so much for spending these last couple chuckers with us. Good luck to you and the Grand Champions, and you guys have a great season.
Thank you very much. I enjoyed it. Thank you.
All right, Joey Casey here with us today, and that, of course, will wrap up our coverage here on Polo Line TV, and we appreciate everybody being with us. Thanks for watching, everybody. A great game again today. We've had two spectacular games here on PoloLine.tv, and we're glad you're with us worldwide. A reminder, we'll be here Sunday. It's 4 o'clock. That's Eastern Daylight Time for the finals of this year's edition of the Nespresso U.S. Open Polo Championship. Again, Zaccaro takes it by 1, 14-13.